On Sunday, 19th February, senior house officers deployed for postgraduate and specialist training at various hospitals across the country declared a nationwide strike over salary arrears. Since they hold a big percentage in the hospitals, their absence negatively impacted on the patients in various hospitals. Today, senior house officers decided to suspend the strike, giving government a one-month ultimatum to fulfill its promise to fully clear their allowances.
It's held a general assembly this week and resolved to suspend the instruction for 1 month as we allow time for engagements to take place to discuss and implement the recommended short-term and long-term solutions as presented by the Uganda Medical Association. So our recommendations, number one, the Minister of Finance, Planning and Economic Development should work in collaboration with the Minister of Health and the Parliament to urgently find resources to pay arrears for all senior house officers. Number two, we recommend that the National Health Workforce Planning Committee should be instituted according to the presidential directives of 1st June 2021 and the Professor Omaswa-led proposal submitted to the Prime Minister's office and the UMDPC, that's the Uganda Medical Dental Practitioners Council, should be addressed immediately for short and long-term strategic planning for generating an effective, efficient and affordable health workforce in Uganda.
The resolution to pay senior house officers a monthly allowance was introduced in 2016 when President Yoweri Museveni, while attending the Uganda Medical Association General Assembly, said that not paying these graduate doctors was an act of modern-day slavery. Payment of senior house officers was meant to start in July 2021, giving them a monthly allowance of 2.5 million shillings. Out of the 6 months demanded by the officers, the government has managed to clear 2 months of their arrears. They have asked government to fulfill its promise to clear their balance on time.
Even senior house officers were admitted, that is less by how many?
13.
By 13. So we can't say that 247 senior house officers are more than 260. Ultimately, it boils down to planning and making proper future projections. And this is one of the recommendations we have made all along, that ministry needs to sit down and plan better. And all this can be resolved through the national task force, which was recommended by Professor Omaswa.
Not always our intention to strike, but when we are placed beyond the wall, against the wall, that we can hardly move and proceed to work on our patients as they are supposed to be, we end up laying down tools. We end up not serving. Yes, as you have all witnessed in the hospitals in which we serve, yes, there has been some paralysis in the service delivery. I can assure you that all the outpatient departments for these last 14 days have been closed.
Countrywide, there are 692 senior house officers deployed in different parts of the country. The strike has had a significant impact on the healthcare system, with patients suffering as a result. Medics say the officers start their day at 6 a.m. and spend the day on ward rounds, performing life-saving procedures, training and supervising interns and medical students, and working overnight call duty on a rotational basis. Upon this background, government has taken a swift action to address the concerns of these doctors and ensure that they're paid what they're owed so that they can resume their vital work in hospitals. Report compiled by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.